couple days ago, I was sledding in the below freezing temperatures of Montana. Today, I am sitting in the probably mid-70s of Southern California. So every year, Stefan's family has this gathering. Whose house is this?
My Aunt Susan.
This is Aunt Susan's house, and they just have everybody over, and everybody makes tamales, and it's a good time.
So how do you make a tamale? We got our corn husks, meat, and masa. Spread the masa onto the husk nice and thin. Make sure you leave a buffer along the edges so your tamale doesn't get all splugy. Scoop some meat on in there, then top it off with an olive.
You fold it this way. You fold it this way. And then you just flip it back, and there's your tamale.
With everyone working around the table like children in a sweatshop, we were able to pump out 300 tamales before evening.
Look at all those tamales.
The tamales all get stuck into a pot. Then a towel is laid on top, upon which some broth is added for flavor. Finally, water is added so that things can get steamy.
It's so hot in here.
So hot.
There's like you can feel like the 20 degree difference from like right here to right here.
It's hot in there. It's really hot in here.
It's all those hot tamales. And now it's time for another yearly tradition in the Chin family, wherein we walk to Trader Joe's.
Well, when you say it like that.
It does sound kind of silly, but it's an important part of Christmas. Look at that Santa, it's dancing. I found the Trader Joe's. That was a pretty short walk.
It is a short walk.
What is it?
It's strawberry licorice.
Why did you have an accent?
Well, because there's kangaroos.
Oh.
And a koala.
So many wines. I found the soft lady fingers. I got told to stop filming in the Trader Joe's. So I'm gonna start a poo-poo list. Trader Joe's is on my poo-poo list. They can go take a on a Why do you think it is that establishments don't like people filming in them?
I don't know.
Are there places that are not poo-poo-y? Or is everything on my poo-poo list?
I don't know, I think everything's on your poo-poo list.
Well, we definitely know Trader Joe's is on my poo-poo list. I recently learned that some people have a specific word for this bit of lawn between the sidewalk and the street, which to me never had a word. According to Wikipedia, this little side lawn thing is known as a road verge, a boulevard, city grass, devil's strip, nature strip, parking strip, planting strip, sidewalk buffer, tree belt, tree lawn, utility strip, parkway, among others.
I like sidewalk buffer.
No, Kendall, stop walking on the sidewalk buffer. No, oh God. I wanna know where the term devil's strip came from. That one's interesting.
Back at the house, the tamales are done steaming, which means it's time to taste the fruits of our loins. Loins? Labor.
Okay, here we go. That's some tasty. Mm-hmm. This is a really good shot of just like your arm muscle there.
I'm gonna flex.
Flex so hard.
Stefan's Aunt Susan made a comment earlier in the day that I liked. She said, in the end, it doesn't matter how the tamales come out, and even in the past, they've had years where the tamales were terrible. The whole point of their tamale-making tradition is to get friends and family together. The tamales are secondary. Maybe that's why I look forward to tagging along every year. Stefan and I have been friends for almost 20 years, so at this point, his family feels like my family, and it's nice to see them for the holidays. Anyway, to avoid going out on a super sappy note, here's a clip of us playing Cards Against Humanity.
Next, from J.K. Rowling, Harry Potter and the Chamber of Pabst Blue Ribbon. Harry Potter and the Chamber of Exactly What You'd Expect. Harry Potter and the Chamber of Elderly Japanese Men.